What's happening, everybody? I hope you're all good. I had a bit of an experience today after one of my speeches, and I wanted to share it with you to tell you what happened. I think I've learned a bit of a lesson, so I thought I'd share that with you as well. It was not a good ending to my speech today. It was the worst ending I've ever had. Well, I don't know. We came good in the end, but it got heated, man, and I didn't handle it well. In fact, I kind of snapped today a little bit. At somebody in my Q&A. So I'm in Norway right now and I'm doing a speech at a festival. Small crowd, one of the smallest crowds I've had for one of my speeches, which was fine. You know, like, you never know who'll be in that crowd. You never know what one of those people might do if you influence them. Even if you only influence one person, helping them go vegan adds years to their life, reduces them from so much suffering. So it's all good, but it was a long way to travel just for like a couple of really small crowds. So I was kind of off it a little bit and tired, like super tired, jet lagged, man, you know. The times are hectic over here, so I'm really tired. And I do my speech today, and at the end of it, in the Q&A, this dude started going on about God and the religion and Bible, and that God, he just kept saying that animals are put here for us to use. And it was driving me crazy, man. Because if people want to believe in religion, cool. I don't believe in that. Personally, no offense to anybody, but I think it's like believing in Santa Claus. You're going to believe in a book that was written thousands of years ago that has all kinds of ridiculous notions like virgin birth and walking on water. It advocates for all kinds of different cruelties like slavery and other, you know, man, all kinds of things that I think are ridiculous to believe in. And then to think that there's this God up there, this compassionate, all-loving God who says, kill and eat some animals, why would he make them sentient? Why would he make them loving? Why would he give cancer to children? Like, I'm not about it at all. I'm not about religion. But I have no problem if someone wants to believe in it. If that will make them happy, go for it. I don't care. I think it's silly, but I'm not offended by it. I don't care. When I start to care is when people use their religion to justify bad behavior. That I have a massive problem with. And that's what this person did today. He was using religion, his religion, to justify killing animals. And this is the most frustrating. There's no discussion against veganism. There's no debate against veganism. It's solid. It's an airtight argument. There's no debate. It's healthier, it's better for the planet, it's more ethical. It's better in every way. Logic always wins these debates, but when you are debating someone who is not using logic, when you are debating somebody who brings in a book and just says, I don't care about logic, I care about what it says in this book, you can't get anywhere with these people. So I said it like this, you know, if you're not going to listen to logic, this is what I'm thinking. If you're not going to listen to logic, I'll say it in your words. So I said, what kind of God, a loving, compassionate God, would advocate for you to mutilate and torture and kill animals that feel pain and suffer like us, that have families like us? What kind of good God would say, sure, it's fine to go and kill and eat them when you could have easily eaten something else? That sounds more like the work of the devil to me, which it does. We're talking about killing babies here, like innocent little baby animals, and killing their mums. You know? It's not loving, man. It's the opposite of that. And this person, and I should state as well, like, this person, I got no bad feelings towards this person. At the time I did, and this is the lesson I've learned. But this person can't help it, man. He believes something, you know? He's been brainwashed his whole life to believe something, conditioned in this way to believe in the Bible or whatever he does, and that eating animals is fine. You know, like, I shouldn't have got angry at this person because he's just ignorant. Like I was 4 years ago before I was vegan. I didn't care about animals either. You know, like, I shouldn't have got angry at this person. But instead, he kept going on, man. You know, he couldn't understand what I was saying. I was saying, why would you be cruel when you don't have to, you know? Why would a good God want you to do that? Doesn't that sound more like murdering animals, innocent animals, vulnerable beings who feel pain and suffer? Doesn't that sound more like something the devil would do? Doesn't that sound evil to you? This doesn't sound loving, you know, slitting throats. It's not loving and feasting on their murdered bodies. That's not loving. And man, we just went at it, eh, me and this dude. And it got heated, I got super frustrated. This has never happened to me. I've done over 150 speeches. I've never lost it at a dude. And I lost it, eh? Sign of how tired I am, you know, but I shouldn't have lost it. And so anyway, I'm going off at him just like you're an idiot, man. Like, you're not listening to reason, to logic. You're saying you're against animal cruelty, then you're saying there's no problem with killing animals because it says it in the Bible, because God said it's okay. You know, like, ah. So there's no reasoning with that, logically, because it says it in the Bible. And I said, well, in the Garden of Eden, it was vegan. And he said, he said, it wasn't making sense. He's like, yeah, well, were the animals in the Garden of Eden? I said, yeah. He said, exactly. I'm like, but no one was eating them. I don't know, he didn't make sense. It was frustrating. And anyway, then, what happened after that? So, I don't know, we went on for ages. And in the end, I just said, look, believe in God if you want. That's cool. I don't care. But forget that for a second. No religion mandates that you have to eat animals. God doesn't say you have to eat animals to be a good Christian. Neither does Allah, neither does whoever, any of them. None of them say you have to eat animals. You have a choice. So why? As a good person, I'm talking to this man. I'm like, you're probably a good person, a compassionate person. I'm sorry if I'm being aggressive. I'm having a bad day, you know? But I still think you're probably a good person and want to do no harm, you know? I'm sure if there was an animal here right now and I was punching it in the face, you would come over because you'd have a problem with that. And you probably put your own safety on the line to try to stop me, even if you would usually eat these animals. You're probably a good person, right? Why then, as a good person, would you choose to harm the animals when you don't have to? Why would you choose to do that when God doesn't tell you you have to, when you could easily eat something else? Why would you choose to do that? And the dude didn't really have an answer to that. He just kind of was like, why are you getting aggressive? Why are you getting aggressive? And I said, man, I tell you why I'm getting aggressive. Because I care about these animals. Like, my voice was shaking. It was pretty hectic. I was like fully fired up. Because I care about these animals and you are talking about murdering them as if it's okay. That's why I'm getting fired up here, because you are using your religion as a justification for violence. And that's why I'm fired up, mate, because I'm frustrated because you're probably a good person and yet you don't even see how cruel what you're talking about is. Is gonna kill them because you like how they taste. And you're going to say that God said it was okay, so you're not even going to feel bad about it. In fact, you're going to feel like you're doing the right thing. Of course I'm frustrated, mate. You know? And he said, you're acting like this is the worst thing in the world. Man, this is bad. It's murder of innocent beings. Doesn't matter if they're not humans. Humans are animals too. You're killing families. You're killing mothers. You're killing babies. It is bad. Anyway, I went hard on this dude, and then I stopped and I said, there's a couple of good things in the Bible. Hate the sin, love the sinner is one of them. I don't hate you, bro. You know, yes, I've aimed aggression at you today. I'm sorry, I'm extremely tired. I'm not in a good place today. It happens, I've never done this at the end of a speech. Today's the day, sorry you had to be on the end of that, but you've been frustrating me a lot. Also, forgive them for they know not what they do. I'm gonna forgive you, man, because I don't blame you because you've been brought up like this. No hate, you know what I'm saying? But please think about what you're advocating for here, all this unnecessary violence in the name of God. What kind of good God would enjoy seeing you do that to innocent beings? That ain't God, man. And I don't know. I don't even know where I'm going with this. Oh, yeah, I do. I wanted to talk. This is, and what all this comes back to, obviously that whole argument, that's how I feel about religion. I don't think it's good when you're going to use it to justify violence. I think it's wrong. You want to use it to promote love and peace? Mad. Cool. Do it. That's fine. Do I think the story is ridiculous? Yes, I do. If you believe that all that happened, 100%, just because it's in a book, I think that's ridiculous. No more ridiculous than believing in Santa Claus or the Tooth Fairy. That's how it seems to me. But no hate to anyone who believes in it. Cool, you're welcome to, you know, whatever. What I realized from today is that you gotta look after yourself, man. I feel like one thing I bring to the table when it comes to vegan activism and spreading this message is peace and compassion and patience and respect to other people. And I lost that today. And I don't regret it because we still had a really good conversation, and in the end I definitely brought it home, and I told the dude I respected him, and later he came up to me and he said, man, I'm sorry if I offended you, whatever. And I said, mate, it's all right. You know, we're cool. Sorry about the aggression. You just pushed my buttons the wrong way today, and I don't appreciate talking about like that to these animals, about these animals, you know. But it was all good. I don't regret it. But what I learned is that this is definitely not the best way I could have handled this situation. Sure, anger has its place every now and then, but I would have had more credit. I spent that whole speech, it was a speech about vegan advocacy, half of it was. I spent that speech talking about spreading this in a positive way, and I usually do that 150 or whatever speeches before this one. I've done that. All my Facebook posts for the last couple of years. You know, I used to be a bit more aggressive, whatever. I changed because I saw that this works so much better when you're positive and compassionate and patient and respectful with people. I've seen how much better it is, man. It plants so many more seeds, and people change. Like, people are changing like that with me now compared to back in the day when people were putting up their defenses because I was being more on the attack. You can't do this the best way if you're tired and if you're not looking after yourself and not if you're not enjoying life in some way. I haven't been meditating lately as much. I've been really good up until when I got to where I am now, Norway. You know, like with all the travel, just in the USA, then I was just quickly in Australia. I'm super tired. And I haven't been looking after myself as best as usual. And I thought, oh, I'm cool, I'm fine. Like, I'm getting away with it. You know, I haven't meditated for a while, but I have been really positive and life has been really, really good actually. Up until the last couple of weeks or whatever, something like that. I've been a little bit more tired and stressed out. But the point is, I thought I was cool. I thought I was sweet. I haven't been meditating. I haven't been looking after myself as much, but it hasn't really affected me. And that's how I kind of felt. And today I realized it definitely had affected me, and you know, I don't want to be just like a mediocre activist or a mediocre advocate of veganism. The animals deserve more than that, and that's why I usually really step my game up and focus a lot on the things that I know help me be a good activist, like meditation, like being positive, like getting enough sleep and exercising and all these kind of things. They put me in the best headspace, and headspace is so important when it comes to spreading this message in a way that, in my opinion, is the most effective for most people. So this message I've taken from this, and I hope you will take this as well, is that self-care is so important for the animals and for yourself. You burn out, you get tired, you get sloppy, you can't do it in the best way possible. And that's what I've experienced today. It has been such I was so rattled after that experience. I never go off of people like that, man. You know, it was just a bad ending to an otherwise really good speech. And I said, I'm like, look, don't take this example as how this should be done. Everything I said in my speech, I meant. I just cracked a little bit today. I stand by everything I say in my speeches about spreading this message in a compassionate way. And I know I would have had better results with that dude today if I had done it the way I usually do it. So I feel bad that that happened a little bit, because I just think I could have got through to that dude better knowing how I usually am. And that's the activist I want to be, and that's the activist I usually am. So, man, so I need to sleep, basically. I'm in the gym, obviously, but I need to do that as well because it makes you feel good. Anyway, so that, I just wanted to share my story with you, you know, because it's real, man. You know, I'm not a perfect person, and I slip up as well, of course, and make mistakes, but I think when you make them, there's always a lesson to learn. Own it, apologize if you're sorry, learn your lesson, do better for the future. For me, I've really noticed that when I'm not meditating and on my A game, ticking those things off my checklist that make me the best version of myself, it has affected my activism today, and I'm not okay with that. You know, that's not good enough in my opinion. I have high standards of myself. So I'm glad to get that wake up call, because, you know, that'll inspire me, motivate me to get back on track with those things and start ticking them off the checklist again. I hope you all had a good day. I hope you've been enjoying the YouTube videos I've been smashing out a bit more lately. Thanks for watching them. Thanks for all the positive feedback. I read a lot of the comments on those videos, and yeah, just thank you all so much for all your support, everything like that. Next video, I'm hoping, is going to be much more positive than this one, but thanks for checking it out. Thanks for joining me on my journey with me. Thanks for joining me on my journey. And here's to more self-care, better results, and more peace inside here and outside there.